Hi, everyone. This is Charles Hoskinson, broadcasting live from warm, sunny Colorado. So real quickly, Alonzo Purple is out. We've just spun it out. I think we're going to hard fork the network here in a second, the test net, and we're going to begin systematic onboarding of the exchanges and other people. We did some tests with Alonzo White for those exchanges, and everything looks pretty good. Rosetta's in QA, QL is, GraphQL is done, and DBSync looks pretty solid and stable. So we're going to get a lot of data next week from the exchange partners, but so far everything on our internal testing looks pretty good. If all signs point to clear, then we should be able to get that HFC event for Alonzo done in short order. If some things are discovered, then they'll be quantified next week, and we'll put it into our launch plan. So I think we're still on schedule for the announcement of when the HFC event is going to be. I believe it's probably going to be announced around August 12th, 13th is when we're going to do the mid-month update, depending upon how all the stuff pulls together and how much feedback we get. We're starting to make some decisions about what the mainnet candidate is going to be for the node that we're going to launch for the HFC event. And there's some questions about whether to include some optimizations or not. If we include some optimizations, the mainnet candidate node will be pushed a little further out, which means we have a shorter period of time for the testnet for the exchanges to upgrade. But then there's some added benefits to the node. If we leave those out, then we'll have to include them in the next hard fork combinator event that will be probably before the end of the year. But that means there's a little bit of gap of time. So we're doing a lot of simulations work and testing right now. And we're just finalizing a few things like cost model and so forth. But all things considered, it was really good to see Alonzo Purple announced today. And Wallet Backend, I believe, is integrated. A few rough edges here and there, but looking good. And Daedalus work is underway for integration of Daedalus into the stack. So next week, probably the 12th or 13th, we'll have the mid-month update. We'll have a roll-up of everything we've learned. We'll kind of talk through all the stuff. And what we'll do is announce the HFC event. We'll also talk about what happens after the HFC event and where we're at with the Plutus application backend integration and where we're at with the other parts of the ecosystem and tooling and kind of a tentative flow for how things are going to go there. About 200 people were onboarded to Alonzo White before we moved off of it, and we'll have a much larger set of people with Purple, a lot of industrial partners in that respect. Dark Purple, so this is light purple, dark is for the PAB, and that'll be after the 10th of September. And we'll be rolling all the Plutus Pioneers and all these other people there, and you know, they'll have a great testing surface for everything. There's been some questions of why not wait for PAB to be completely done and run everything through one universal test net? Why do a fractured thing where we do an HFC, but we're waiting for some dev infrastructure to be in place so that you can use the surface language and all the libraries and tooling? The reason being is there's just simply too many people to upgrade. So we have over 100 exchanges and different wallets and other people. And if you have everything hit at the same time, it's a little problematic from a QA support perspective. So it made a lot more sense that once the node is stable and the backend is stable and we can survive a hard fork without changing the underlying infrastructure and everything else is just parameters and tooling, to get that out of the way so that everybody can upgrade prior to a huge wave of smart contracts hitting the network and putting the network under load. It's very important that that infrastructure gets laid down and we're okay with it. And not everything hits at the same time. So it also gives us a little bit more time to think carefully about the dev cycle. And if we miss anything, we can always clean it up in another hard fork combinator event at before the end of the year. Because we know we have Genesis coming and peer-to-peer coming and all these other things coming. So in that launch roadmap, it makes sense to do it. But what's really cool is the 5 seconds after the HFC event occurs, you can run Plutus code on Cardano. So we're already talking to Lars and other people like Kevin Hammond about, well, what do we want to deploy just to kind of show them things off? And if you're really creative and really understand our stack, you guys actually can start writing and deploying your smart contracts on mainnet if you so choose, which is pretty awesome. Or you can wait 2-3 weeks and the test net will be in a position where you have the full Cadillac experience and you can write stuff and deploy it there. And the analogy to understand if you're from the Ethereum world is the difference between the Ethereum virtual machine writing it on the metal and Solidity. So there you go. Just want to give you guys a very brief update about that stuff. So congratulations, we're in the Alonzo Purple era. We moved from blue to white to light purple. We're chugging away. We're moving along very quickly. Next week is going to be a really busy week. There's just so much shit to do, but we'll get through it. And based on everything we learn, we'll be able to know what's realistic and reasonable for an HFC. And then we're off to the horses, and it's a lot of support. So thanks, everybody, for all the work. It's been a lot of fun. And actually, this one's a lot smoother than Byron the Shelley. A lot more is being upgraded, but it's the process of upgrading has been so refined that it's amazing. We can just, you know, flip a switch as an ecosystem and it just works on the other side. So that's going to be fun. The other thing is we're going to have a watch party. I'll be live with the team as we roll over from Mary to Alonzo and start deploying some things for fun. And I'd love for you guys to join us on that. We'll live stream it. And I'm certainly going to open up the whiskey. If you guys have some champagne or wine or other things to open up, I recommend now is the time to consider it. I'd love to see the community host its own watch parties around the globe for the event. So as soon as we announce, you guys will have a few weeks to figure out the logistics of that. And maybe the foundation will do something fun. Okay. Talk to everybody soon. Cheers. Mm-hmm.